Hi, Alexey.
Hello, Arkadi.
We met before together with HR and department managers in a conventional job interview and discussed your experience, success, projects, your motivation to work in our company. And today I would like to ask you to join me in a short programming session and develop a solution for a small problem so I can get the idea of your software development skills.
I would be glad to work with you.
Okay. So our team tries to stick to agile and test-first practices, and we use occasionally a pair programming for hard tasks. So for a start, I'll give you a task like a user story, and we'll try to develop a solution together behind single screen and keyboard. So the environment we will be working in is a Cyber-dojo software, freely available and created. This software is created by a great guy. His name is Jon Jagger. It's a web-based environment, quite minimalistic. You'll see it, but suits our task well. Here is the task. The task itself is to create a converter of a positive integer and determine its Roman numeral representation as a string. So you can read the task on the screen. Probably before we start coding, let's discuss the architecture of the solution a little bit.
Yeah, sure. So I guess we should implement only one method to convert a positive integer to Roman number. I think I will use HashMap to store the keys and values of Arabic numerals and Roman numerals, so I can easily convert an Arabic numeral to Roman one. So my method will take as argument a common integer and return a string value that represents a Roman numeral.
Okay, fine, I agree with you. And in general, during our session, just ask anything you need to know.
Yes.
And please also describe what you are doing and why you are doing so.
Okay, so I can start coding.
Yeah, yeah. Right.
So first of all, I need to prepare my workspace by renaming all the classes so that they will suit our needs. So I guess the name will be Roman number for my class. Its method should return string value.
Mm-hmm.
Let's call it convert. And it should take as a parameter a simple integer that we'll call num.
So you're currently doing
I'm just making refactoring to prepare my workspace.
Mm-hmm.
So, Roman number. I will rename the file as well. Roman number. Okay. So, next up is our test. I need a mockup for our class. So, let's make it private.
I believe it's not a mock-up, but it's an actual implementation of the functionality.
Yeah, okay. Static, private static, Roman number. Roman. And Roman equals. Okay, so I've implemented the instance. Now I'm going to write it here, Roman. Okay, so to rename the test file Roman number. Yeah, so now the test should fail. Oh, it seems I forgot something. Oh, it's in the shell file. Yeah, we have to.
We need to. That was incomplete refactoring. We need also the rename files in compile script.
I guess it's done. Let's check. No Roman convert actual.
We need to supply an argument to
the convert function. Sorry, it's done. Yeah, now it fails. So now we can start implementing our
conversion.
So first of all, I want to create a map that will map keys that represents integers to values that are our Roman numbers.
Yeah. Previously, you told that you were using hash map. Do you think the hash map suites?
So we need a.
We need to actually
a sorted, a sorted map.
Yes,
so I will guess I will take tree map. So let's import it. Import Java utils. I will import all the utils because we are not working in the real file, and it will be simpler for us if we forgot to import something. So map. Let's call it dictionary. Dictionary. Let's write generics. Generics are integer to string. Okay. Map integer. It should be private, and let's make it.
Just keep it instance.
Yeah, okay. Let's keep it without static. So now I'm going to override the constructor, the default one. Yeah. Override. And add the dictionary. So I've mapped keys to values that represents Roman numbers, and now I'm going to invoke the get method of a tree map as our return value. So dictionary.get num. So this should be sufficient to get the Java. I forgot the semicolon. Yep. Override. It's kind of a declaration. Strangely, but okay. Yeah, so it passes now. Next up, let's create a new test case. And call it test 20. So in this test case, we should test if our program can convert a two-digit Roman number. So
into
two-digit Roman number. Yeah. So we provide a 20 as a parameter, and now our program will fail. Our test will fail. Yes, it fails. Now let's implement the code. So first of all, as our result value can be with multiple digits, let's create a result, a string builder result. And we'll return it as a string. Yeah. So the idea of the architecture is to create a for each loop that will check all possible keys and values in our map and see what kind of Roman digit can we extract from our Arabic number. So that should do the trick. Let's run the program.
Okay, we are out of heap space, and why it is so?
So it was a syntax mistake. I forgot and typed less, but it should be more. Okay, so now we run the test, and it...
We see it.
Yeah, and now it fails, because our tree map is sorted the wrong way. So I need to provide a comparator for the tree map. The collection class has a method called reverse order. And it should do the trick. Maybe it's a syntax mistake. Yeah, it's a syntax mistake. So yeah, now our test passes. And let's write another test. Now,
what do you want to test?
Now, test. We didn't implement numbers like 4, 9, 40, etc. So those numbers will provide it now. So let's
those numbers have different rules.
Yeah,
right?
Different rules. So now let's test for 9.
Okay.
It should return a I and an X. Test will fail. Yes, it fails. So now let's write down additional rules. It provided to our dictionary so that the test will pass. Okay, so I provided additional dictionary entries like put 4 I V, and now the whole tests should pass. Yes, and they passed. Now the only things left to do is test for 0 and test for large numbers such as 5,000, because Roman numbers doesn't have numbers that are more than 400. So 4,000, sorry. So first of all, I will test for 0.
What do you expect from
test? If we test 0 or something that is inappropriate for our function, it should throw an error.
Let's discuss the type of the exception, the convert function.
So Java libraries have an illegal argument exception, so we'll throw it from the code. But now let's make the test fail. Yeah, it asserts false, and now we'll implement a simple if statement.
Let's add some human recognizable message like
number isn't handled.
Is not representable as Roman, for example.
Number C close none. Yeah.
And just formatting. That's space, right?
Yeah, okay, so let's check. Now it should pass. Yes, it passes. Now the only test left to do is test for numbers more than 5,000. Run the test, it fails, and we just add
or
num num equals 4,000. Yep. So now the test is complete.
So you believe the task is complete?
Yes.
Okay. So we finished this task quite in short time, and do you think there is still room for improvement?
Yes, so I can mention two rooms for improvement. First of all, I don't like those additional dictionary entries that I've put data. The second thing
What about this number? What is it?
Yeah, so,
Okay. We finished with the kata, so just explain what you can do with that.
Yeah, also, to make code more usable, I could...
Or visible.
and visible, I could make constant values to provide programmers
to name the constant.
Yeah, so yes. It would be more readable and maybe more reusable. Yes.
Okay. What other finding do you have any after the exercise besides the technology and the task itself?
And you forgot to do something because you're doing test by test. So maybe, I don't know, you should for start think about your whole architecture and then start with tests, not doing it in the same time.
Okay. Thank you for your time.
Yeah, thank you.